Howdy, nomads. Well, this video is shamelessly going to be about me, or at least the people I've known. It's going to be about my lifestyle over the years and the reason that I've had so many different groups of friends that have come and gone and now have disappeared into history, which is rather sad for me. So I decided to make a video about it, not so much for your enjoyment, but really is just a record of that part of my life, you know. So, you know, I've led a fantastic life, but also a very strange one. I've spent my whole life moving through doing one thing and then meeting people there and finishing with that, going on to do a completely different thing, meeting people there, finishing that, going on to a completely different thing. And every time I move on, I lose the people that I met in the early days. There's not going to be any, very little mention of family in this video, because everyone has family and everyone loses family. I was kind of unfortunate enough to lose all of mine through natural wastage, and others have come along in my family. I've subsequently learned, but I wasn't there to get to know them. So all the family that I know have gone. So there's going to be very little of that. So it first started after school, and there are one or two photos that, of school friends that I don't see anymore, but I can say that I don't see 100% of the school friends, and I'm only in contact with maybe two at most. So apologies if your photo isn't among them. After leaving school, I went to college and I spent some time in London getting the qualifications to enable me to go to sea as a electronics officer in the Merchant Navy. So I met people there, and when that series of courses came to an end, I got a job for a shipping line, and that was the end of them. So I spent some years sailing around the world and spent on average about 6 months on every ship, where I'd meet a new group of people and then pay off that ship, never see them again, go to another ship, meet a new group of people, and so on and so on and so on. You can see where this is going, can't you? Then came a very long period of at least work stability, is when I joined the BBC. I joined slightly late for this, but I joined as a decky learner. It was really meant for school leavers having their A-levels. Though all the other people I joined with, and we were a small knit group, all the other people I joined with were about 18. I was around about 20. So to them, I was an old man, you know, but we all got along really, really well. And I still know about all of them nowadays. I never meet them anymore, but they're there online and whatever, and I can communicate like that. Two of them have died, but the majority of us are still around. That was all at the training centre in Wood Norton. And after that, we moved on to our careers. Some of us split up, some of us stay together, but I spent about 14 or 15 years in the BBC, gradually moving up the ladder, again doing one job and then another and then another, and meeting different people and discarding them. Part of that time was what I call my Battenhurst era, where I got together with some people I worked with, and we became very close. Two of these families, they bought a huge house down in East Sussex and shared it. And I got to know them and their families very well, and also the other families in the village in East Sussex where they lived. So that was a good part of my life, and one or two photos of that, if will be in this video. But sooner or later, that had to come to an end when I became a contractor and moved abroad. The vast majority of those people are now dead, in fact. It's very, very sad. So after the BBC, I resigned from the BBC and became an independent contractor, which enabled me to travel basically all over the world. So again, moving from one job to another and people passing through your life at one end and passing out of it again at the other. I moved for many years. I lived in the USA. In fact, I'm a US citizen, and I plan to go back there at least for some time in the near future. I ended up living in Tombstone in Arizona, where I went through my cowboy era, and you'll see a little bit of that. Two or three of my very best friends in Tombstone are now dead, so they're wandering the streets of Tombstone with Wyatt and Doc and Ike Clanton and all those good guys. Maybe I'll join them one day when all this is done. But the overall theme of all of this is unchanging, moving from job to job, position to position, and friends to friends. So I've got to say, there are whole eras of my life that are missing in the memory department and in the photographic memory, in the photograph department. In the memory department, my early childhood, I remember almost nothing about, and I suspect that something went radically wrong there in my childhood. I'm not sure what it was. It may have been mental illness. I don't know, but I've got very few memories of it. In fact, my memories of childhood don't really pick up until I went to junior and secondary school. So there's that. I've got very few memories of that. Now, very few photographic records of that. Few from school, although most everyone loses most of their school friends. I'm still in contact with one or two. I've included some photos of that. I've lost all my college friends, none whatsoever. They're just images in black and white photos now. I did have a whole raft of photos from my Merchant Navy years, and I'm damn sure I digitized them, but I cannot find them, so I'm afraid they're going to have to go absent without leave in this video. And that's it. There's nothing I can do about it. I had two major relationships in this in the 80s and 90s, and both of them were pretty disastrous. And the first one I have no photos of because I wasn't encouraged to take any photos. And the second one was so disastrous that I destroyed all photographic and video records of that relationship. So I have nothing. And I'm glad, because I just don't want to remember it. I don't want to remember it. You have to understand that most of my life has been in the days before iPhones came in, and even digital photographs, you know, and the concept of taking photos on a film camera and sending the stuff into the chemist and whatever always filled me with disinterest. So I'm not too crazy about that, and that's why there is a lack of photos of that era. Anyway, that's what's coming. I hope you enjoy it, and this is my tribute to all of the friends that I once knew and once liked and loved and are with me no more. Enjoy.
About a mess of feelings. me crazy and I don't know you yet, but I miss you.
Well, I hope you enjoyed it. Probably meant nothing to you, but it means a lot to me, and that's what it was all about, really. My own records. At the end of the day, when I'm not here anymore, all of the videos I put on YouTube will be some kind of record that at least I was on this earth, because no one else is going to remember it. So there we are. Those of you that follow my videos, I hope you enjoy, and thank you very much for following my videos, and I hope you get something out of it. I certainly get something out of making them, and I hope to be walking around the streets more in the near future, moaning about stuff. That's my particular talent. Okay, thanks, and bye-bye.